Okay, I'm on the roof here at the 10 Suites of 2000 Beach Street in Fort Worth. We're taking a look at the roof over the kitchen area, kind of the maintenance kitchen area. They've got some really bad leaks inside, leaking in both coolers and out in the open there. This particular roof, I'm not going to core it today, but it's just by looking, it looks like it's probably got two roofs on it just because of the depth of these drains. Normally these drains wouldn't be this deep in a roof. So what I think they did is they laid an insulation board over the existing roof and then just mopped another roof. This thing was probably done 15 or 20 years ago. It looks like it's got some age on it. Here along the walls here, there's a flashing that runs underneath this counter flashing. It's all pulling away from the walls, falling out. So this entire building is leaking around the peripheral, around the perimeters here. I'm just walking around this perimeter and you can see this. Hopefully in this video, there's some photos that we're going to take of this while we're here. This video is done October 14th, or Thursday, 2010. Here's a big hole right here in this corner. You can see where water's just flowing in there. Pretty typical for this entire roof. On the stucco wall, I don't know if it's going to show up in this video or not, but it has some cracks in it. All down this wall. A lot of times that water seeps behind that stucco and then drips inside the building. This area we're looking at here is where some roofers have tried to do temporary stop leaks. I can tell by the material they used. Also, this is some old stuff they tore out of the roof here and just left it on the roof. This is over the laundry area with these big vents. Today I was asked by one of the maintenance people and the manager here just to take a look at this particular area and see what we could do to patch it. And this is a view of the equipment over the refrigerators inside. The boards are rotted out and they're just sitting down in the roof, and I'm sure water's just coming in by the bucket loads around this unit. Really, to successfully even make an attempt to patch this roof, what we'd have to do it right is just to go ahead and disconnect these chiller condensing units temporarily, jerk all that stuff up and roof under it, and then place them back. That would be the ideal situation. I think we've covered everything that we're going to cover here today on this. And this is Larry Kinsey signing off.